गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द पावर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स फंडामेंटल ट्रेनर किट। बाय दिस ट्रेनर किट वी विल स्टडी द वीआई कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ डिफरेंट पावर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स कंपोनेंट लाइक एसीआर, डायक, ट्रायक, आईजीबीटी, मॉसफेट, यूजेटी। हियर डिफरेंट डीसी पावर सप्लाईज आर देयर, प्लस 5 वोल्ट, प्लस 12 वोल्ट, प्लस 15 वोल्ट, प्लस 35 वोल्ट, सिमिलरली माइनस 5 वोल्ट, माइनस 12 वोल्ट, माइनस 15 वोल्ट, माइनस 35 वोल्ट। And here some AC power supply, 18 volt and 15 volt. This two are potentiometer. By taking this fixed power supply, we convert into variable power supply. Here three terminal is the input, then ground and output. Here some resistor, inductor, diode, capacitors are there. By this component, we can connect commutation circuit and chopper, and cycloconverter, inverter, etc. This is the pulse amplifier, here is the pulse transformer, and this is the triggering circuit required in the rectifier circuit for firing of SCR. This is the single phase rectifier section. From this we will get the triggering of SCRs, and here 4 SCRs are there. This is basically used to construct a rectifier and etc. Let us study the VI characteristic of SCR. For this we have to make the circuit arrangement like this. Here the SCR, this is two variable power supply, DC power supply. This power supply is used to connect the anode cathode, that means this is the anode cathode voltage, and here a 5 watt 120 ohm resistors are there to protect the SCR. This is the multimeter connected in series to measure the anode current. And to get the gate supply or gate pulse, here the another DC source is there, and this is the voltmeter and ammeter. Basically we will measure this gate current, then we will draw the curve between this voltage and this current, means anode voltage, anode cathode voltage and anode current, by changing this potentiometer. Now let us connect the circuit as per the circuit diagram. Let us study the VI characteristic of SCR. For this we have to connect the circuit as per the circuit diagram. Here I will take the plus 5 volt, so plus 12 volt, and I will connect to the potentiometer. Then from here I will connect to 120 ohm, then other terminal of the resistor, connect potentiometer. Potentiometer to resistor, and give 1 watt. So the terminal. This is my DC1, this is my DC2. Okay. Then to measure the anode cathode voltage, I will connect a voltmeter against the anode cathode terminal. This is the anode current I have connected in series, and this is my anode cathode voltage and connected across the anode cathode, that is connected in parallel, and this is my gate current. Now let us do the reading of VI characteristic. What we will do here, by changing the anode cathode voltage we will get the different value of anode current. Now first of all we will give some gate current then increase the anode cathode voltage and you will get the SCR will turn on after some time. At that time the voltage will decrease suddenly and current rises gradually. Then by changing the another value of IG, you will see in the first case the turn on voltage will be less than that of the second case. Here I have make this ammeter is a anode current, so I will make it in milliampere range. This is my anode cathode voltage, so I will make the DC voltmeter, and this is my gate current which in some microampere. Now I will turn the power supply. This is my DC to I will increase to some value, let's say 30. I am keeping my gate current as a 40 microampere. I will start increase gradually the anode cathode voltage. This is my anode voltage. Look at here. This is some millivolt. Then this is 0.6 volt. At that time, my anode current is 0.05 milliampere. Then if I will increase then to 0.8. No conduction. Okay. If I will increase to the gate current to 42 microampere, then I will see the changes in anode voltage and current. I am gradually increasing my anode voltage. Here you have seen suddenly then at some 1 point some volt the voltage decreases, then here current gradually increases. Similarly, if you change the gate current to 44 microampere, let's say, then you will study what will the anode voltage and anode current. Here anode voltage increasing. You have marked here in the previous case when I will give the gate current is 42, I have seen my the SCR will conduct at some 800 millivolt, but here when my gate current increases to 44, SCR will conduct before that gap. And here you have marked the anode voltage, anode current increasing gradually. In this way, by changing the different value of gate current, you can draw the curve between the anode voltage and anode current. And from this all, we have concluded that when IG1, IG2 and IG3 different value of gate current, by giving the more gate current, the SCR will turn on quickly. If you not give any gate current, then SCR will turn on when it reaches to its break cover voltage. Okay, thank you very much. By taking this reading, you will plot the graph. Thank you.